In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to animate this abstract shape's walk cycle. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. We'll use loop expressions and a few different animation techniques to make that little guy move. Alright, let's dive right in. First of all, the usual. We create a new comp, name it walk cycle, HD resolution 1920 by 1080 pixels, 3 seconds long. Then we double click on the rectangle tool to create a new shape. Solid fill, color, whatever you like, it's red for me. No stroke. Let's name it square. We open the rectangle path property, uncheck constraint proportions, and set the size to 300 by 300 pixels. Let's move it down a bit into the lower half. Then we duplicate the rectangle. Select it and first of all change the fill color into blue. Then we add round corners to it. Open the property, let's increase the radius to make it a perfectly round shape. Then let's reduce the size to 50 pixels. Next, with no layer selected, we grab the pen tool and draw a straight horizontal line below the square. No fill. White stroke. Width around 6 pixels. Let's name it floor and move it below in the layer stacking order. And we position it below the lower edge of the square. Let's animate the square. First of all, we move the anchor point to the bottom right corner, holding Command or Control if you use a PC to let it snap into place. Now we easily are able to animate the rotation and position, and the square stays on the floor like it's supposed to be. We set a position and rotation keyframe at the beginning. At 10 frames, we set the rotation to 45 degrees. The position is minus half the width, minus 150 pixels, 960. At 20 frames, it completely fell on the right edge. Rotation 90 degrees. Position minus 150 pixels again. At 29 frames, we set keyframes again. Alright. The animation is linear, but seems right. Next, let's add the arm, which pushes the square over its edge. At the beginning of the timeline, we use the pen tool again and draw a line from the center of the square to the floor, left of the square. Let's name it arm. No fill, stroke white, width 25 pixels. Let's zoom in here a little bit. We go into the stroke property and set line cap to round cap. Let's be exact here and center this point using the arrow keys. And let's adjust the other one as well. Zoom back out. Then we select the path, go to window, and select the create nulls from path script down here. Then we choose points follow nulls, which creates two null objects, one for each point of the line. We link the one in the center to the square shape using the pick grid tool and set a position keyframe for the other one. At 10 frames, the square has moved 150 pixels to the right. The upper point sticks to the center, which is nice. The arm needs to move 150 pixels to the left for the object to actually be pushed forward. At 20 frames, we move it above the upper edge, pointing straight up. At 29 frames, we copy the keyframe from the beginning. Then we need to take care of the motion path. We use the Convert Vertex tool to turn this bottom part into a straight line. The rest of the path needs to be round. Let's see. That looks good, but still way too linear. So we select the first 6 keyframes and add easy ease to them. Next, we open the graph editor to edit the speed curves. We slow down the beginning and end of this first part. The speeds of these first animations need to be exactly the same. That's why we change all the speed curves at once. Then we select the position and rotation of the square and speed up the end of the animations as much as possible. Next, we select the line path position and slow down the beginning and end. The end is probably too slow. That's probably better. The point in the middle is at the top, meaning the fastest part. Let's check it out. Awesome. It's looking good for me. Alright, let's make a loop out of it. We add an expression to the first position property and simply add loop out to the second line, which creates a loop. Once the last keyframe is played, they simply repeat again. We repeat that for the other two properties. One animation cycle takes exactly 29 frames, so let's set the end of the work area to 58 frames, which is exactly twice the length. Awesome! That's the base animation. Now let's add an additional element. We go to the beginning of the timeline, choose the ellipse tool, double click on it to create a new shape. Uncheck constraint proportions and set the size to 280 pixels each. No fill, white stroke, width 6 pixels. Let's name it circle. Then we position it on the center of the top edge. Let's move the anchor point to the bottom point, holding command or control again to let it snap. Next we set a position keyframe at the beginning. Let's make all keyframes visible. At 10 frames, it's on the corner. 10 frames later, it's on the next edge. At 29 frames, we set another keyframe. Then we open the graph editor and edit the speed graph. First of all, we speed up the end part as much as possible, like before. Then we slow down the beginning and end of the first part. Let's see. Maybe a bit more. Awesome. Alright, as you probably can see, we need to go through and adjust the positions. So let's do that. The beginning seems good. We go through frame by frame and adjust the Y positions using the arrow keys. Awesome, that's looking good. Let's add a little detail in this part. At 22 frames, the circle moves up again, a few pixels. At 25 frames, it's back on the edge. Let's add the loop out expression to this property as well. Awesome! Check out the free project file to see how I animated the small round shape. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell, because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, guys!